click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, welcome back to Electromagnetic Field Theory. We are in chapter number 5, Conductors and Dielectrics. Up till now in this chapter, we have gone through the concepts of what is current, the current density for different configurations of conductor shapes. Later on, we have gone through the current continuity equation, and in the last video, we have seen exactly the behavior of conductors for the electric field. We have derived the boundary conditions also. Based on the behavior of the conductor, whatever the relationships of the drift velocity, electric field intensity, charge configuration, current density we have seen, let us begin with solving problem number 1. So here we have problem number 1. The statement is, find magnitude of capital E bar in a sample of silver having sigma is equal to 6.17 into 10 to the power 7 and mu suffix E is equal to 0.0056 meter square per volt second. If we have 4 parts, A part, that is the drift velocity, is 1 mm per second, part B, current density is 10 to the power 7 ampere per meter square, part C, the sample is a cube 3 mm on side carrying a total current of 80 amperes, and lastly the part D is, the sample is a cube 3 mm on side having a potential difference of 0.5 millivolt between the opposite faces. Now to read the problem statement, what information we get. In the very first line, we are asked to calculate, find the magnitude of E bar. So E bar we represent for electric field intensity, which we call the strength of electric field. Okay, so we know the relation, if the source is stronger having higher magnitude of charge, that time the electric field is stronger, so correspondingly the electric field intensity will also have higher value. So we are asked to find the magnitude of E bar. So mod of E bar, magnitude of E bar, electric field intensity we have to determine. For what? For a sample of silver material. The material is a silver material. It has sigma and mu suffix E. In the last video we have seen the sigma is the representation for conductivity of the material. For perfect dielectric, conductivity sigma is equal to 0. For perfect conductor, what we have seen in the case of deriving boundary conditions, the conductivity sigma is equal to infinity. So practically sigma will have some value for the conductive or semiconductor materials. So for silver material, sigma is given to have the value 6.17 into 10 to the power 7. The unit should be mho per meter. So it is per unit length conductivity. And mu suffix E is the representation of mobility of the free electrons in the material. So mobility is given to us, that is 0.0056 meter square per volt second. So we have conductivity value, we have mobility of free charge carriers, I say, and we are asked to find the magnitude of electric field intensity. So we have two given values. Further, the conditions are provided for all the four parts, and in every part one more information is given to us. Here the two given values we are having. Now in the part A, the drift velocity we generally denote by V suffix D, Vd is provided, and that is equal to 1 millimeter per second. In part B, current density is 10 to the power 7 ampere per meter square. Generally we denote the magnitude by J and the vector J bar. In part C, the sample is a cube 3 mm on side carrying a total current of 80 ampere. So total current we represent by the capital I, and we are also provided the dimension of the material under consideration, that is silver, that is 3 mm. So here we have 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 given values in the part C, and we are asked to find magnitude of electric field intensity E bar. And in the last part, we are said the sample is a cube, again 3 mm on side, having a potential difference of 0.5 millivolt between the opposite faces. So whatever the silver material under consideration is, so it is of cubical shape and it has 3 millimeter on side. So the potential difference between the opposite sides of the cube is given to us. So here also we have four given values. So for solving the part A, we are given the three given values. For part B also three given values. And for part C and D, we have four given values. And with this much of given data, we are asked to find the magnitude of electric field intensity. So let us begin solving from part A. So here we have conductivity sigma, mobility mu suffix e, and the drift velocity denoted by Vd. So we are required to find the magnitude of electric field intensity. So let us have the relationship with the drift velocity and electric field intensity. Now we know that the relationship between the drift velocity and electric field intensity is given by Vd is equal to minus mu suffix e times capital E bar. So this drift velocity, as it is because of the drifting of the charge carriers into the silver material here under consideration, it will also be directional. Hence I put bar over its head, so it is of vector type. So drift velocity Vd is given by minus multiplication of the electron charge carriers mobility into electric field intensity. So here drift velocity is given to us, mobility of electrons in silver material is also given to us. We are not given electric field intensity. Here in this problem, we require magnitude of electric field intensity, means mod of E bar. So first of all, we determine E bar from this relation. E bar will be equal to minus Vd bar upon mu suffix E. So we are interested in only the magnitude. Hence, we write mod of E bar is equal to minus mod here, and drift velocity magnitude we put. Drift velocity is given to us, that is 1 mm/s. So for determination of magnitude of electric field intensity, in the numerator we put the magnitude of drift velocity. The drift velocity is given to us, that is 1 mm/s. Hence I write in the numerator 1 × 10⁻³. In the denominator we are having mu suffix e, which represents mobility of free electrons or charge carriers in the silver material, and mu suffix e is also given to us, that is 0.0056 m² per volt second. So I put here 0.0056. So if I have this simple division and multiplication, so I get the value of electric field intensity magnitude represented by mod of E bar equal to 0.1785. So as this is electric field intensity magnitude, I have to put the unit volts per meter. So this is the required answer for part A in the problem number 1. So this was the problem statement. We are asked to find the magnitude of E bar with sigma, mu suffix E, and the Vd given to us. So let us concentrate on part B. We are given sigma, conductivity, mobility, mu suffix E, and current density. We shall be representing it by J bar, and we'll be calculating magnitude of E bar. So for part B, first of all, I note down the given values. Sigma is equal to 6.17 × 10⁷. It should be in mho per meters. Mu suffix E, that is mobility, is given by 0.0056 m² per volt second. And the third value is given to us, that is current density. I put the magnitude only, that is 10⁷ ampere per meter square. Now we are asked to find the magnitude of E bar. So here we require the relationship between the current density J with electric field intensity magnitude E. So we know the relation, that is also called as Ohm's law in field theory. J bar is equal to sigma E bar. J bar is equal to sigma E bar. So from this Ohm's law of field theory, we write mod of E bar given by mod of J bar upon sigma. So J bar is with us, that is 10⁷, and sigma is also with us, that is 6.17 × 10⁷. If we put both the values, we get the answer 0.1620 volts per meter. I have to put as the unit for the magnitude of electric field intensity. So this way we are covered with the part B also. This was the problem statement. We were provided the current density and these two values, and we are able to find the magnitude of E bar, so that we have determined to be 0.1620 volts per meter. Now let us focus our attention onto the part C. In part C, two values are given to us. The sample of tube is having 3 mm side and it is carrying total current I is equal to 80 amperes. So first of all, I write the given details. Sigma we have 6.17 into 10 to the power 7 mho per meter, that is conductivity. Mobility of free electrons is 0.0056 meter square upon volt second. So this is for part C. We have total amount of current I, that is 80 amperes, and let us say the side of the cubical material silver is given by 3 millimeter, 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. So now for part C, we require magnitude of electric field intensity, E bar. So the relationship between the current and E bar is directly not with us. We have the relationship of current density with E bar, that is electric field intensity, what we have used in the previous, that is part B. So that relationship was J bar is equal to sigma I. J bar is equal to sigma E bar. So here for determination of electric field intensity, we have sigma, but we don't have J bar directly, but we have the total amount of current and the length of one of the side of that cubical material. So this can also be found out. So let us find first of all the current density J in magnitude. So J is given by J is equal to capital I upon A, or capital S you can write, for the surface area. So here we find the current density magnitude by dividing the total amount of current I upon the surface area represented by capital A, or you can represent capital S also. As the shape is a cubical shape, so the surface area will be given by side square. So here I put capital I to be the 80 amperes and the surface area. So surface area will be side square and the side is having the length L. So that is L square. So L is having the value 3 millimeter, 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. So here we have 80 upon, in bracket I put 3 into 10 to the power minus 3, it will be squared. So this is our J. Now we require electric field intensity magnitude. Our problem statement is this. For all A, B, C and D, we are required to find magnitude of electric field intensity. So again, we use the relationship of the current density and electric field intensity. So we have magnitude of electric field intensity given by J upon sigma. So J just now we have written, so we substitute that value in the numerator 80, in the denominator we have 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 square, bracket square, and sigma is also in the denominator, so we put the value of sigma, that is conductivity, 6.17 into 10 to the power 7. So upon simple multiplication and division, we get mod of E bar, that is magnitude of electric field intensity, equal to 0.1440. As this is electric field intensity, I put the unit volts per meter again. So this is the required answer for part C. So this way we have covered part C also. In part C, 80 amperes of current and 3 mm of side of cubical material of silver was given to us, and the value we have determined 0.1440 volts per meter. Now we begin solving last part of this problem statement, that is part D. So here also the sample is of cubical shape and it is having 3 millimeters on side, but we are not given the total amount of current passing through, but we are given the potential difference. Generally, we represent V suffix AB, capital V suffix AB, and that potential difference is generally from the initial position B to the final position A. So here we have the initial and final positions to be the opposite faces of the cubical material. So for part D, let us write first of all the given data. The given data is sigma is equal to 6.17 into 10 to the power 7, that is mho per meter conductivity. Mobility of free electrons is given 0.0056 meter square per volt second. We are given the potential difference between the two walls, that is VAB is equal to 0.5 millivolt, and we are given the side length of the cubical material silver, that is equal to 3 mm, so 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Now the cubical shape, if suppose, is like this. The potential difference is between the opposite faces. So if this is one of the face, the opposite face will be this one. So between these, we have the potential difference 0.5 millivolt. So what is the distance of separation from the initial position, let us say this side, to the final position this side? So it will be the length of this cubical shape, and that is given by 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Moreover, we have to determine the magnitude of electric field intensity. So with this much of given details, we write the relation, that is E is equal to magnitude, E bar is equal to potential difference upon the length. Because we have the unit for electric field intensity volts per meter, potential difference has the unit volts, and the length of the cubical shape is in meters. So it is obvious that the magnitude of electric field intensity is actually volts per meter. So potential difference with respect to the length of the cubical silver material under consideration. Hence we can write here the magnitude of E bar given by the potential difference value V upon L is equal to 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3, as it is millivolt, and length is 3 into 10 to the power minus 3, 3 mm. So we have the value of magnitude of electric field intensity E bar, mod of E bar, is equal to 0.1666. So I have to put the unit volts per meter. So this way we are covered with all the four parts of problem number 1, A, B, C and D. For part D, we have the answer 0.1666 volts per meter. I hope you have understood well the concepts to determine electric field intensity, if conductivity of the material, mobility of charge carriers, the current density, the drift velocity and the potential difference are given to us. In the subsequent lecture, we are going to solve one more problem based on the concepts of conductors, properties and boundary conditions. To get more information on electromagnetic field theory, please subscribe to EKIDA channel. Thank you.